Hello YouTube people, I already did first impressions video on this Steeldive watch and major points, major opinion hasn't really changed much, but I just found one major design flaw about this watch which I would like to tell you about. Also, a quick reminder, that first impressions video is also a review of Steeldive store on AliExpress. Very interesting story, by the way. Check it out if you haven't seen it. The link in the description. Also, in this video, I'll show you how this watch looks like on a bunch of different straps, just for fun. First of all, I'm gonna just go straight to the major point and tell you what kind of a major design flaw I found about this watch. Speaking about this major design flaw, there is a website, thomaswatchreviews.com, where I rate watches into different tier lists. And initially I thought I'm gonna rate this watch as a keeper because it looks incredible. It feels wonderful and it's very good value for money. I haven't changed my opinion about those major things. But speaking about that major design flaw, also, I don't know, this is one off bad unit or all of them are going like that. I don't know, I can only speak about the one I have. So the problem is that even though the crown is big and grippy, it is so overprotected with those huge crown guards that it's very difficult to use. Especially it's very difficult to screw it back in all the way back. I can't do it with my naked fingers. I have to use some kind of a cloth to give some extra thickness on the crown, some extra grip. Otherwise, I cannot do that with my naked fingers. So I don't know. This is just one off. Or all of them going like that, but that's the reason why I'm not putting this watch into keepers. It goes into not bad. And there is another problem with this watch, but before I tell you that, just keep in mind that I think that for the money, even if this watch would arrive in separate parts like hands, movement, case, and you would have to assemble it yourself or give some kind of watchmaker to assemble it for you, I would still say what you get for the money is still incredible. So keeping that in mind, another problem is that hands are misaligned. When I set hands on 12 or 6, you can see there is a misalignment. Not a big deal to fix, but I just have to point out that quality control is still a little bit questionable. So yeah, only two negative things about the watch. Other than that, I can tell only very strong positive things about the watch as the lume of this watch. Very strong lume, very big fun factor, absolutely love it. Another thing about this watch technically, which I like very, very much, is the bezel action. It is incredible. I couldn't ask for anything better than that. Grip is wonderful and friction is also wonderful. And other positive things are completely technical, like 200 meters of water resistance, ceramic bezel, sapphire crystal with anti-reflective coating, Seiko NH35A movement. I never had a single problem with these movements from my experience. They are just great. And however bad it is, but it's still a screw down crown. You screw it in as hard as it is and you have an ease of mind in terms of a water resistance. So all good. And speaking visually, I just absolutely love how this watch looks like. So speaking about the looks, let's have some fun and try it on some different straps. So starting with those custom straps, first of all, very interesting thing that this watch has straight handling design. So if you're gonna put some custom bracelet with straight handlings on this watch, it gonna look like original, like it was designed to be that way. So it's very nice that you can buy a bunch of different bracelets with straight handlings and not worry about it, because when you put them on this watch, they look just original. It's very nice. And another three options that I would like to show you are tangible elastic bands. And I think they just fit the character of this watch very well. First one is this gray option, which I think looks very good on many different watches. This one is no exception. It's just very easy on the eyes. Another one is the black one, which I personally worn the most on many different watches. I really like the comfort and I like how it looks like. This one is no exception. Looks right as well. And another one is military style green, which I think fits this watch the best in terms of a look, because this watch is kind of militaristic and this military green color as well fits the theme. So yeah, it looks like it was originally designed to look that way. Another option is thick silicone strap, It works very well with this watch. This watch is not a small one, it's heavy watch, and it balances it out very well. Also those big holes, very good throughout the summer. Another one is my favorite on this watch. It's just a brown leather strap, a single piece leather strap. I really like how it looks like. It feels wonderful. It's very soft inside. Even though this is the cheap one, it costs less than 2 euros. It still looks wonderful, and in comfort, it's just excellent. So this is it. All I wanted to show you, all I wanted to tell you about this watch. But to the end, I have a question to you. If you have the same watch, tell me in the comments, how is your crown? Is it difficult to screw it back in all the way? Or this is just one off bad example that I got. So for those people who are looking to buy this watch, they can read the comments and see how it is. Is this one off or all of them are bad? Anyway, thank you for watching. Have a beautiful day. Goodbye.